Okay, I'd like to show you how to make how to use the goal seek feature in Microsoft Excel. You can use this to do what we call bottom-up accounting. Bottom-up accounting means that the bottom line has to be a certain amount and you have to make the other numbers fit into that. So we call that bottom-up accounting. In this particular spreadsheet, I have a principal amount. Let's say we're talking about a mortgage. I have a principal amount, the term, which is the number of years, and we have the annual interest rate. Okay. If I come over here to cell D4, D4 actually has a function that's called PMT. PMT means payment. And there's three parameters basically to the payment function. The first parameter says C4 divided by 12. If we look at the spreadsheet, C4 is our interest rate. Actually, the payment function requires the monthly interest rate. So that's why we're taking C4 divided by 12. The second parameter is B4 times 12. B4 is the number of years. Well, the payment function needs the number of months. That's why we're multiplying that by 12. And then A4 is the principal amount. So the payment function actually takes the principal amount, the interest rate, and the term, and calculates the monthly payment. Well, here's where the goal seeker comes in. Let's say that you decide that you can afford $1,500. I'm just using that as an example. Let's say you can afford $1,500 for your monthly payment. The question then becomes, how much of a principal can you afford? Okay? Well, the goal seeker can give us that exact same result. So we're going to click on, you click on the cell that has your formula. And then in this version, the goal seeker is under the data menu. Then under the data menu, we're going to go to what if analysis, and we're going to go to goal seek. I'm going to move this window so you can see what's happening. All right, so where it says set cell, that needs to be the cell that has your formula. In our case, it is D4, okay? And then to value, 1500 is what I want D4 to be. By changing what cell, in this case, by changing A4. So it says set cell D4 to value 1500 by changing cell A4. What are we asking for? We're saying what number does A4 have to be so that D4 is going to be $1,500, keeping the same form that we already have. When I click on OK, it actually comes up with a value for A4. So when A4 is exactly 179,331, then keeping the same formula, D4 is going to be $1,500. Notice how D4 still has the formula. So what it did is it reverse engineered that formula and then made D4 become 1500 by reverse engineering the formula and putting the value in A4. So we call that the goal seeker, and that helps you with bottom-up accounting.